watching Beyond Breaking News,
where the news is of the people,
for the people, but by the youth. I am Vijay Vani.
And I am Vijay Kovid. And we will be your hosts for this bulletin.
From national to international, from health to technology, let's find out what's making news this week.
But before we begin, let's take a quick look at the headlines.
UK calls for early general elections.
Blast kills 22 in Manchester.
New banking rules implemented in India.
And well, no tobacco day.
UK has been in the news for some time now. Brexit hogged headlines, not only in Europe, but all over the world.
And now, British Prime Minister's proposal to hold an early general election is grabbing world attention.
After a lengthy debate, 522 parliamentarians voted in favour of the country going for early elections.
Why does Abhinav and Umang bring us the details?
Last month, British Prime Minister Mrs. Theresa May formally triggered the two-year procedure for leaving the European Union, setting March 2019 as a deadline for departure.
Although she had promised the country that elections would not be called for before 2020, she was parliamentary support as Brexit negotiations are expected to be difficult.
UK will now go to the polls on 8 June.
And here is why Brexit is so important.
What does Brexit mean for Britain's economy? The Brexit victory sent economic shock waves through global markets and Britain lost its top AAA credit rating. But the Bank of England cut interest rates and took other emergency steps to stop UK from slipping into a recession.
If UK slips into recession, foreign companies will be less likely to invest there and could relocate their headquarters out of UK.
What will happen to immigration when Britain leaves the European Union? Brexiters have argued that Britain is now free to take back control of its borders in order to curb immigration and increase security. The UK will no longer have to accept free movement of people from Europe because it is preparing to leave the EU's single market.
A large number of the immigrant population have already started the process of moving out of Britain, saying they no longer feel safe.
If PM Theresa May's Conservative Party wins a majority, she would not require to call the elections until 2022.
Opposition parties are campaigning for the referendum on Brexit. Former British PM Tony Blair is all set to return to politics with a strong anti-Brexit movement.
8 June will reveal if the people of Britain are in support of all the events which led up to this movement, especially Brexit. This is Vijay Abhinav.
And this is Vijay Mang with camera person Sylvia, signing off for Beyond Breaking News.
However, the general election campaigning has been suspended as terror strike UK yet again. As fans were leaving the Manchester Arena after a concert by pop singer Ariana Grande, an explosion was set off by a suicide bomber.
ISIS has claimed responsibility for the attack. 22 people lost their lives, including children, and at least 59 were injured in the blast, which was caused by an improvised explosive device.
Worst terror attack to hit Britain since the July 2005 suicide bomb attacks in central London, in which 52 people were killed.
World leaders have condemned the attack, calling it an act of cowards.
Our next story is about something which affects each and every one of us.
After demonetization, India is waking up to many changes in its financial and banking sector.
What are these changes? Will they impact everyone? Is anyone exempt?
Vijay's Gia and Sylvia answer all those questions. Take a look.
Last year's demonetization gave our country a nudge towards cashless economy.
In a bid to push people to cashless transactions, the major private banks of our country like ICICI, HDFC and Axis Bank have reintroduced transaction charges on withdrawal and deposit of cash.
HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank and Axis Bank are now charging Rs 150 per transaction for cash deposits and withdrawals at the branch beyond 4 free transactions in a month.
These banks will also charge if the monthly average balance is not maintained by the account holder. This would apply to savings as well as salary accounts effective from March 1st. The rates being fined in case the MAB is not maintained, differs in metropolitan, urban and rural regions. The HDFC Bank would also cap the third-party cash transactions at ₹25,000 per day.
Are you aware of the new transaction fees and penalties being charged by major banks? What do you think about it?
No, I don't think branch should impose transaction fees and penalties.
No, absolutely not. I don't think this is the wise decision because there are majority of our Indian people who are not educated. For them, collecting money, keeping in the bank is really a difficult thing. There might be some who might be benefited by it, but I don't think all of them because they really do not know the charges about it, and it will be difficult for people to convince that it is a wise decision and it will going to be used in the development.
Yes, it should be charged fairly and the amount should go for the development of the country.
Yes, I think it is a good decision taken by the government.
Yes, it is good. The government should impose penalty for the people and the money should be used for poor or a labor.
No, I'm not aware of it.
Is anyone exempt from all these above mentioned charges? Yes. Senior citizens and minor account holders are free from all these additional charges.
Along with these private banks, SBI too announced similar charges which came into effect this April.
Be alert, be aware and be better plan. There are 4 free transactions, right? On this note, this is YJ Gia.
And this is YJ Sylvia with camera person Maureen, signing off for Beyond Breaking News.
World No Tobacco Day is observed on May 31st every year. We all know the harmful effects of tobacco use. But have we ever given a thought to what it caused the country towards treating these resulting diseases?
Can we quantify the loss we feel when losing a loved one to tobacco-related cancer?
Why does Maureen and Ira bring us this thought-provoking story?
Every year on 31st day, our World Health Organization and its partners mark World No Tobacco Day. It is a day to spread awareness about its harmful effects.
Tobacco advertisement has been banned in India in 1995. Every TV channel carries warning of use of tobacco.
The theme for the World No Tobacco Day 2017 is Tobacco, a Threat to Development.
This is a macro outlook. Diseases caused by tobacco use are broadly classified into respiratory diseases, cardiovascular diseases, tuberculosis, and cancer.
In a report titled Economic Burden of Tobacco-Related Diseases in India, it revealed that the Indian government spends millions of rupees in the treatment and prevention of these diseases. Cardiovascular diseases treatment is the highest, at ₹3,600 crores, treatment of respiratory diseases cost ₹2,800 crores, tuberculosis treatment cost ₹2,300 crores, and cancers ₹1,400 crores.
Let us make it micro, because it is important for the governments and policymakers, but it is also important for me, you, and all of us. So let's look into our families and our close friends.
Do you know anybody in your family or your close friends who smokes or use tobacco? How do you try to stop them?
No, nobody have this bad habit in my family.
Actually, none of my family members have this habit, and I feel so glad to say this.
Yes, we do have neighbors who smoke, and I think I will put in a request where I'll tell the authorities to make the locality tobacco free and also create a non-smoking zone, and a fine should be put up on those who smoke.
Actually, one of my family members had this bad habit of chewing tobacco, but we persuaded him to stop because it harms all of us and it should not be done, and gladly he realized how bad is that and he stopped.
Actually, mere ghar mein koi smoke aur drink bhi nahi karta hai. So isse sab dur hai.
Yeah, one of my distinct relatives, he smokes. I try to dissuade him by telling him that how it affects not only him but also his family.
George Bernard Shaw said, "A cigarette is a pinch of tobacco rolled with a paper with fire at one end and fuel at the other."
Yet how many of us allows our loved one to smoke and use tobacco? If you really love them, you need to stop them. It is as simple as that. This is YJ Maureen.
And this is YJ Ira with camera person Anumit signing off for Beyond Breaking News.
Are you facing troubles due to the cash crunch in the country?
Are you tired of trying to figure out ways to make digital payments using complicated applications and net transactions?
Well, there's a good news. An easy-to-use mobile application designed by Prime Minister's Office has just been launched.
Secure gateways, alphanumeric passwords, and digital payments may soon be a thing of the past. Why just Tahat and Janvi bring us the details of the new Aadhaar Pay app.
On April 14, 2017, the Government of India launched Aadhaar Pay, a digital payment platform for merchants.
27 banks went live at the launch on April 14.
The technology have designed in such a way that the customer do not need any device to make a payment.
All they need is their bank account should be linked with Aadhaar so that they are able to use their thumb impression for authentication.
The Bheem Aadhaar Pay payment app has been developed along with UIDAI and National Payment Corporation of India. This payment app eliminates the charges currently charged by card companies such as MasterCard and Visa.
The app makes cashless transactions possible even for those who do not have mobile phones. However, the merchant accepting the payment has to have a mobile phone. The app uses biometric scans as passwords. This means that users can use their fingerprint or biometric data to validate a transaction.
Merchants need to download their Aadhaar Pay app from Google Play Store, and they also need to install a biometric scanner and link it to the app.
Though users don't need any password or app, it is mandatory for them to have their Aadhaar number linked to their bank accounts to make the payments. The app needs internet connection to work. This is unlike debit or credit card machines which work on telephone lines.
Aadhaar has already given a unique number to 1.11 billion people of the country.
Out of these, 400 million people have joined their Aadhaar number to the bank accounts.
India is going cashless. Are you? On this note, this is Vijay Janvi.
And Vijay Chahat with camera person Ira signing off for Beyond Breaking News.
With that, it's time for a short break.
Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Coming up on the other side, staying healthy in summer.
Keep watching Beyond Breaking News.
Are you ready?
When you hear the words summer vacations, what comes to your mind?
Holidays, food, games, TV, friends, books, enjoyment?
Yes, it's quite a long list, but it also includes falling sick, right? Why does Ashvi LM bring us some do's and don'ts to help us not fall sick?
Summer means heat, sweat, upset stomach, inactivity.
And all that leads to irritation. And irritation, and that makes us scream.
Once we explain you the ABC of scream, I mean summer, you two will like to follow our leads.
So, we are going to take the letters in scream and rearrange them into something positive for summer. Let's start with S. S is for sun protection. Use sunscreen that has SPF 30 or higher with UVA and UVB ray protection. Apply liberally to all exposed skin at least 15 minutes before you plan to step outdoors.
C could be for common sense, but in this case, let's use it for cotton. C is for cottons. Light colors reflect, dark colors absorb. So, the lighter and looser they are, the better you will feel. Cotton and linen fabrics are cool and comfortable. Avoid synthetic fabrics as much as possible.
It was so difficult.
to come up with an R. The word just kept running away from us till we hit upon the word running. R is for right way to exercise. Seriously, you can't use summer as an excuse to not exercise. If you go for a run outdoors, go early morning, late evening, or where there is plenty of shade. So, the next letter is E. We are free. No school and home all day, so we eat. E is for eat fresh. Eating fresh fruits and vegetables is one of the simplest ways to reduce the heat from your body. The next letter was a no-brainer. A is for aqua. This summer, you need to cut down the solids and increase your liquid intake. Drink enough water. Carry a bottle of water when outdoors. Coconut water, vegetable and fruit juices are a good idea too. Keep yourself adequately hydrated.
And the last letter, you all will agree, is for something a lot of us ignore. M is for medical alertness. Avoid being outdoors during the hottest hours of the day, that is 12 noon to 3 p.m. Avoid working intensively outdoors during this time. If you happen to be with or come across someone who is going through a stroke, immediately take them to a cool place and hydrate them.
So, are you going to let weather dictate the terms of your life? What you gonna do? You are going to S-C-R-E-A-N. On that note, I am Vijay Ashri.
And I am Vijay Hem with camera person Chahat, signing off from
Beyond Breaking News.
Our next story is about hard work, some wins and some losses.
Yes, and it is also about victory and reaching one's career best rankings.
Which sport are we talking about? Who is the super achiever? What has her career graph been like?
Vijay's Tanisha and Avanya bring us all the details of how PV Sindhu became world number 2.
The Indian Open Super Series saw the country's favorite badminton player score a decisive win over her nemesis of the Olympic Games.
Yes, PV Sindhu defeated Carolina Marin in straight sets to clinch the title. This win earned her 9,200 points in the Badminton World Federation World Rankings.
Add this to the 71,599 points she has already accumulated with 15 title wins. PV Sindhu has now become world number 2 women's singles player in badminton. Let's take a look at her career graph. The world sat up and took notice when PV Sindhu broke into the top 20 of the BWF world ranking in September 2012 at the age of 17.
In 2013, she became the first ever Indian woman single player to win a medal at the Badminton World Championships. In 2014, PV Sindhu reached the semi-final stage of 2014 Commonwealth Games.
In 2015, she reached her maiden final of a Super Series event at the Denmark Open, but lost at the finals. She, however, won her third successive women's singles title at the Macau Open Grand Prix Gold.
Her silver medal win in women's singles event of the 2016 Summers Olympics, the first Indian shuttler to reach the final of an Olympics badminton event. She became the youngest Indian to make a podium finish in an individual event at the Olympics.
As a doubles player, she has 9 wins and 8 losses. And as a singles player?
Well, out of the 280 matches she played, she lost only 82 and she won 191 matches.
This win at the India Open Super Series had made her the world number 2 player. We hope that it won't be long before she becomes world's number 1.
On this note, this is Vijay Tanisha.
And this is Vijay Avanya with camera person Lehim. Signing off for
Beyond Breaking News.
That brings us to the last story of this bulletin, which means it is time for some entertainment.
We all have our favorite genres, favorite actors, and even favorite film industries. Hollywood, Tollywood, Bollywood.
This story takes you straight to Hollywood and tells you about some of the upcoming movies to expect in 2017.
Vijay Arpit brings us the list.
Lights, camera, action. Our words that filmmakers live by, each scene, each character, each dialogue carefully created. And we, the audience, just slap it up. Regional, Hindi and even English films. Watching movies with families and friends is just the best ever. So we decided to help you plan your Hollywood calendar for 2017.
My dear Belle, you're so ahead of your time. This is a small village.
You are the most gorgeous thing I've ever seen.
Nobody. We have already seen a couple of the big releases like Beauty and the Beast and Logan, which released in March, April this year.
Much like you.
The feelings disappear.
In May, we will get to see some of our favorite franchises. Jack Sparrow is back in Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales.
We have to find it.
Alien Covenant. Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. And Terminator Genesis 2 are other movies to look out for in May.
My whole life I prepared my son to lead humanity in the fight against the machines.
Vacations are still on and June will not disappoint us. One new production from the House of Marvel and one franchisee, Wonder Woman. And yet another Transformers movie, The Last Night 2, is due in June.
Can't do this.
School has started, but these three are a must-watch. Independence Day 3, Spider-Man Homecoming, and War for the Planet of the Apes are all set to release in July.
It will be a planet of apes.
Wow. I think apart from Wonder Woman, all were sequels. But the list is not over yet. Thor is set for a November release and Star Wars and Jumanji will entertain us in December. And these were just the icing on the cake. We have started compiling the next list. Till then, this is Vijay Anumit with camera person Tanisha signing off for Beyond Breaking News.
On that note, we come to the end of this bulletin.
This is Vijay Kovind.
And this is Vijay Vani signing off for
Beyond Breaking News.
Where the news is of the people,
for the people,
but
by the youth. Goodbye and take care.
She would not require to be called elections for 2022.
Sir, dobara roll kar.
Bhaiya, pledge le rahe. Opposition leaders are in the meanwhile campaigning for the referendum on Brexit.
PM Theresa May, Conservative Party with
150 per transaction for cash deposit and withdrawals at the branch beyond
four transactions.
For deposit of cash and withdrawals.
In a bid to push people to camera, HDFC and Axis Bank have reintroduced transaction charges. Sorry, ma'am.
Every TV channel carries
a World Health Organization and its partners marks World No Tobacco Day.
Every TV channel carries a warning. Carries.
George Bernard Shaw said. George Bernard Shaw said a cigarette is a pinch of tobacco, which is.
Old enough.
Idiot.
Huh? Which he has designed in such a way that the government of India launched Aadhaar Pay, a payment.
27 people.
God. Once we explain you the.
Or are you going to rule it yourself? I know. You are going to S-C-R. Tell me, what you gonna do? I know.
Yes.
On that note, I am Vijay Ashri.
And I am Vijay Lehem with camera person Charles.
Score a decisive win. Signing off for Beyond Breaking News. Well, my eyes.
Lights, camera, action. Out. But the list is not over yet. Thor and Jumanji vs. ये क्या हो गया?
Coming up on the other side. Staying healthy in summer.
Keep watching
Beyond Breaking News.